respected staff, non-teaching staff, co-workers and beloved alumni. I greet you all in the name of God. Today we celebrate our Loyola Family Day. On this great occasion, I wish you all a happy feast and remember our great founder of the Society of Jesus, Saint Ignatius of Loyola. I feel sad that we cannot even meet personally and convey our greetings to each other. But however, we accept this situation and support one another during COVID-19. We often remember you all and your family in our daily prayers. Father Bosco, our former superior, is transferred to Vijayawada, and in his place, Father Sandanasamy is appointed our superior and correspondent. I welcome him on behalf of you all. Along with Father Sandanasamy, Father Peter Daniel and Father Naveen will present a small video presentation about the great contribution of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. M-A-G-I-S, Magis. Magis means more. It is about being more, doing more and achieving more for oneself, for God and for the entire humanity. Magis is a desire to strive for something better, greater and more challenging. We desire for constant improvement and in the attitude of being a lifelong learner. Magis is a restless desire for greater things, a deeper attentiveness, a deeper spiritual life and more meaningful relations. The second aspect of Magis is excellence. Excellence is the gradual result, always striving to do better. It is not a skill, but it is an attitude. It is a quality rather than quantity. Excellence encourages everyone about life in general, and it shows the spiritual wealth of the world. On this beautiful occasion, we shall ask ourselves and raise few questions within ourselves. 1. What more can I do to strengthen my spiritual life, family life and students' life? 2. What more can I offer to improve slow learners in my class? 3. What more in my work or life or relationships can I do to bring greater good to my life? Dear teachers, ultimately, Magis is ongoing growth and questioning ourselves. How can we live bolder, better, and more loving? Once again, I wish you all a happy feast and request you all to be safe and healthy. God bless.
Respected staff members, I am Father Sandanasamy, the correspondent of Loyola Public School. Greetings to you all. This is to wish you all a very happy feast in honor of Saint Ignatius of Loyola, the patron of our school and founder of the Society of Jesus. I'm sure all of us are safe from killer virus corona. We wish you with God's blessings and protection. The inspiring phrase, born for greater things, the motto of our school is attributed to a very young Jesuit, Saint Stanislaus Kostka, who proved so saintly during his short religious life, born for greater things. We know that humanity has grown in civilization with ideas. Ideas rule the world. Every discovery, invention, and creative venture is the product of ideas. In fact, ideas mold the destiny of every knowledgeable person. Our work as teachers is precisely to make our students to think. As a basis to our teaching, be it the teaching of maths, science, commerce, and arts, we motivate our children to be critical but positively, to face difficulties courageously, to solve problems cleverly, to take decisions firmly, and to act prudently. We require to extend our personal touch in the form of giving them hope, confidence, and support. We require to feed them with the ideals of a creative ambition and realistic goal in life. We need to promote a practical approach to their learning. Above all, we need to accompany them in their character formation, showing them the true way to one God, the Father and Creator of all things. We inculcate in them a reverence to God, along with mutual respect for people of every religion, caste and community. On this day of Loyola Feast, dear teachers, let us renew our pledge to the school and vow to do justice to our teaching and submit to God the entire school for His blessings. Thank you.
Ad Maiorem Deum Gloriam is the motto of St. Ignatius of Loyola and of the Society of Jesus. Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam, or for the greater glory of God, is the belief that our actions give glory to God and that even indifferent or neutral acts can reflect God if done with the intention of giving glory. How to live out this motto? To live Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam is a way of being that permeates every thought, every deed, every action and inaction. All is contemplated and weighed, all for the greater glory of God. To live Ad Maiorem Dei Gloriam is to lay claim to a legacy of otherness that sets us apart and puts us at ease with any culture or people. It is a heritage of service, however, whenever, and wherever needed. It is a heritage of leadership in service to those impoverished in mind, body, and spirit. It is a call to respect the dignity of each human and the splendor of all creation. It is a complete ability to become aware of injustice, a spirit-driven determination to find a way to correct the wrong, lift the downtrodden, to bind the wounds, to welcome the stranger, the nationless and the outcast. It is to become aware of our place as privileged children of a living God who demands only that we abandon all status and privilege to seek Him and to find Him in all things, people, circumstances and places. To be unattached to any outcome except that which God wills, leaving behind the comfort zones, realizing the ego into the bosom of the Creator. Rooted in the confident security and the joy of knowing love beyond words, unattached to and surrendered to none, but that love called together at one table, unity in diversity, one family and working together to realize heaven on earth. This is the way we are called to live out Ad Maiorum Dei Gloriam by our Saint Ignatius. Happy feast to each and every one of you. God bless.
Two standards. If we examine our life and the world, we find that there is a battle between good and bad, God and evil, light and darkness, continuously going on in the battlefield of our hearts and the world. Irrespective of any religion, everyone is part of this battle. In spite of joining the army of evil or being the commander of evil, we continuously strive to come back and to reach our source of life. Through meditation on two standards, the standard of evil and the standard of God, Saint Ignatius of Loyola picturizes how God with his army through his values and actions helps us to attain self-fulfillment and our salvation. Evil, on the other hand, with his army through his bad values and actions, leads us to the destruction of ourself, depersonalization and dehumanization of all within his reach. Saint Ignatius, after meditation on two standards, invites us, as we are children of light, to join God's army and become part of his mission in fighting against evil, removing the darkness, bad values and actions within us first and then in the world. Thus, God wants us to establish and spread the kingdom of God with his values of life, love and light within us and the world. In our tradition, parents and teachers are equated and honored as God. Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava. In Advaita philosophy, it is said that everyone is God, or part of God. Aham Brahmasmi. Therefore, it is our responsibility, especially teachers and parents, first to fight against bad values and actions within us and eliminate them. And then help our children and students and people in the world to build a heaven on earth. But now it is time for us to ask ourselves where we stand, for good or bad we are fighting, and put ourselves on good path. Thank you.
We conclude our video presentation with a song called Noble Knight, which reveals the visionary mind of Saint Ignatius of Loyola.
We will fight 'neath that sway. Oh, what the foes gather near. We don't fear, we don't fear. We'll not shun, we'll not quit. This a noble career. We will fight ever true to death, to thee. True to God, to faith and thee. True to thee. Lead us on gallantly, gather on valiantly. Need the banner to fight for the church and its rise. All for God's own greater glory is our cry, battle cry. Not for gain nor in vain is our strife in this life, but for God who's our King, all our hearts to Him we bring. Stronger and stronger as fighting lasts longer, and purer to make heaven surer. With crosses and trials and many denials we'll stop, but to die true, loyal to our King who reigns on high. Ignatius, lead us all.